Welcome to a second video on parallel and perpendicular lines. In this video, we'll do a quick review of the definitions of parallel and perpendicular lines, and then we'll focus on determining the equations of parallel and perpendicular lines based upon given information. Parallel lines are two lines that never intersect, and in order for that to happen, the two lines must have the same slope and different intercepts. So the slopes must be the same, and the y-intercepts must be different. And here's an illustration of two parallel lines. Using these two points, we can determine that the slope of this line would be up 1, right 2, so 1 half. And using these two points on the red line, we could also determine the slope is equal to 1 half. And we can also tell that the y-intercepts are different, so we have parallel lines. Perpendicular lines are two lines that intersect and form a right angle. In order for two lines to be perpendicular, the product of the slopes must equal negative 1, or we can also say that the slopes are negative reciprocals. So for example, if the slope of line 1 is equal to 3/4, then the slope of the second line that would be perpendicular to this line would be negative 4/3. So we flip it over and change the sign. And here's an illustration of two perpendicular lines. They intersect and form a right angle, which is equal to 90 degrees. And we can see that the slope of the blue line would be equal to 1/2 using these two points. And using these two points, we can determine the slope of the red line would be down 2 right 1, which would be negative 2 over 1. So we can see there are negative reciprocals, which of course does equal negative 2. Okay, but the focus of this video is to determine equations of lines based upon given information. So on this question, we want to determine the equation of a line that is parallel to this line and passes through the point 6, 2. So the first thing we need to do is take the given line and determine what the slope is. And we're going to do that by solving this equation for y. So we'll start by subtracting x on both sides. It's often very convenient to have a coefficient for x, so I'm going to go ahead and put a 1 here, and now we'll divide everything by negative 3. So we have y equals, this would be positive 1/3 x minus 3. So this tells us the slope of the given line is equal to 1/3. Now since the line that we want is parallel to this line, we know the slope of the new line is also going to be 1/3. So now we want to find the equation of the line where the slope is equal to 1/3 and it passes through the point 6, 2. Now we can do this either using slope-intercept form or point-slope form. Let's start by using slope-intercept form. Meaning we're going to find the equation of the line in this form, and we know that m is equal to 1/3. So we have y equals 1/3 x plus b. Now since this point is on the line, that means it would be a solution to this equation. So we can replace x with 6, y with 2, and then solve for b. So using the point 6, 2, we would have 2 equals 1/3 times 6 plus b. So we have 2 equals 1/3 times 6 over 1, that would be 2. So if we subtract 2 on both sides, it looks like b would be equal to 0. Which tells us the equation of our line that is parallel to the given line and passes through the point 6, 2 would be y equals 1/3 x plus 0, or just y equals 1/3 x. Now I do also want to show this using point slope form. So instead of using y equals mx plus b, we could have used y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. This is point slope form. So using this form, we'd have y minus y1, which is 2, would equal 1/3 times x minus x1, which is equal to 6. And now we'd have to distribute the 1/3 and then add 2 to both sides. So we'd have 1/3 x, 1/3 times negative 6 would be negative 2, so minus 2. And now we'll add 2 to both sides. And as we expected, the result is the same. Now let's go ahead and verify this on the graphing calculator. We're going to enter in the given line in y1 and we'll compare it to y equals 1 third x. So we press y equals, we're going to type in parentheses 1 third x minus 3, and then y2 will be 1 third x. And we'll go ahead and press graph. The slopes are the same, and therefore we have parallel lines. Now we want to determine the equation of the line that is perpendicular to this line and passes through the point 3, 4. So again, the first step is to determine the slope of the given line. From that, we can determine the slope of a line that would be perpendicular to that. So we'll subtract 2x on both sides. We have 3y equals negative 2x minus 6, and we'll divide everything by 3. So the given line would be y equals negative 2 thirds x minus 2. So this slope is equal to negative 2 thirds. Well, the line that we're looking for is perpendicular to this, so that means the slope that we want to use would be the negative reciprocal, or 3 halves. So we want to find the equation of the line that has slope 3 halves and passes through the point 3, 4. Again, we can use point slope form or we can use slope intercept form. I'm going to go ahead and use slope intercept form. So we know the slope is 3 halves. So we know that y is equal to 3 halves x plus b. This point is on the line, therefore this point is a solution to this linear equation. So we'll replace y with 4 and x with 3. I'm going to put 3 over 1 since this is a fraction. So we have 4 equals, this would be 9 halves plus b. So we'll subtract 9 halves on both sides. So we have b equals, well, 4 is actually 8 halves. 8 halves minus 9 halves would be negative 1 half. So that tells us that the equation of the line that's perpendicular to the given line and passing through 3, 4 is y equals 3 halves x minus 1 half. Let's take a moment to verify that as well graphically. So we'll enter these two equations into the graphing calculator. Clear these out. First line has a slope of negative 2 thirds. Second line was 3 halves x minus 1 half. Remember, to check for perpendicular lines, we do have to square the window by pressing zoom option 5 for z square. Otherwise, the angle between the two lines will be distorted, and we can see here those look like they are perpendicular. Let's take a look at one more. Determine the equation of a line that is perpendicular to y equals 4 and passes through the point negative 3, negative 2. Y equals 4 is a horizontal line that looks like this. Well, the slope of a horizontal line is equal to 0, and the reciprocal of 0 is undefined. So let's think about this a little bit more. The only line that's perpendicular to a horizontal line would be a vertical line. So let's plot this point here and figure out what the equation would need to be. Here's the point negative 3, negative 2. So the only line that would pass through this point perpendicular to this horizontal line would be this vertical line here. So the question becomes, what is the equation of this vertical line? Remember that the equation of any vertical line is in the form of x equals a constant. So if it passes through the point negative 3, negative 2, the equation must be x equals negative 3. Okay, that's going to do it for part 2. I hope you found this video helpful.